Well, the unique Sabu in action later on tonight on Saturday Night's Main Event, but from SmackDown, there's the 7'2", 430-pound monster, the Great Khali.
I've seen monsters here at the Sporting Tournament in Dallas.
1 week from tomorrow night at the Great American Bash, The Undertaker will step into the first ever Punjabi prison with this man, the Great Khali. And once and for all, dead man, your legacy will be buried at the hands of the Great Khali, the one true phenom of the WWE, the one true giant of the WWE, the biggest, the strongest, the baddest, the toughest giant.
Well, it's a beach.
Oh, wait. Wait a minute.
It's a beach.
The Big Show, the 7'5", 500-pounder, the champion of extreme championship wrestling.
You want to talk about a giant. I don't know who's going to pay for all this catering, but it looks like Jurassic Park just came to Saturday Night's Main Event.
ECW, the alternative to World Wrestling Entertainment, the brainchild of a man to be Big Show's left, that almost cult-like figure. Paul Heyman, who said that ECW is him, not his soul. But the question is, John, what brings the ECW champion out here?
Not only ECW champion, the first man to hold WWE, WCW, and ECW champions. We've got the two biggest men in sports entertainment today, and they're about to go nose-to-nose, which is impressive when you're over 7 foot.
Speaking of impressive, I believe the Big Show is indeed impressed with the size of the Great Khali. We saw how vicious and dangerous Big Show was this past Tuesday night on ECW on Sci-Fi, the dismantling of the legendary Ric Flair in a bloody, a vicious battle. But what brings the champion out here tonight?
I think the simple fact that Daivari said he had the one true giant. We're fixing to see him get it on.
Ooh, man, you're a big boy. Let me just tell you a little bit about who I am. You see, I'm the Big Show. I'm 7 foot, 500 pounds of extreme ECW champion. Now you see, I'm the only man walking this planet who has held the WCW heavyweight title. Thank you very much. The WWE heavyweight title and the ECW heavyweight title. Now I admit you're a big man, and one day you and I got to find out who the real giant is.
I got money on our SmackDown giant, Khali.
See, but that's not why I'm here. I'm here, actually. I'm here to put you over. I can't put it any more plainer than that.
What?
I got to put you over. The way you have single-handedly dominated The Undertaker.
What?
I haven't seen anything like it. The Undertaker, the phenom, the walking dead man. You have had his number. You pinned him by putting your foot on his chest.
Oh! Oh, my! It's fixing to pick up. This can mean only one thing. And there he is, the legendary. Until now, he's thrown punk card after punk card down for The Undertaker. It was just last night on SmackDown that The Undertaker appeared for the first time since Judgment Day.
Undertaker. More importantly, funeral services are about to begin. Very few times do you get to see a legend on his last day. This right here could be it. This is an extremely volatile and extremely dangerous situation, ladies and gentlemen. Extremely volatile, Harold Michael. It's like a fire and gasoline. We got something fixing to blow the roof off the AA Center right here on NBC. The battles between The Undertaker and Big Show have been legendary in the past. And we all know what the great Khali has done to The Undertaker. For months, I have wondered where The Undertaker was, and now he's back. He's got both of them, and he's staring at both, and he's not backing up an inch. I cannot believe that The Undertaker would step into the ring with these two giants at the same time, in the ring at the same time. As many times as I've battled that man right there, I've been to hell with him. I've never seen fear, and this impresses me more than anything he has done in his entire career. That's a 7-foot-tall Clint Eastwood stepping in with two Jurassic Park giants. And Undertaker unloading with right hands. The first physicality between these two men since Judgment Day. And Undertaker trying to unload on the 430-pounder. And Khali has been knocked out of the ring by the Phenom. And look at Big Show. Yeah, that's typical. Look at Big Show with the ambush from behind. You know what that is? That's smart, Michael. What he did was he's a 500-pound decoy, which is hard to beat. And here comes Undertaker exchanging the right hands with the ECW champion, The Big Show. But what we have right here is the pride of SmackDown against the pride of ECW. Something you can see right here on NBC for the first time ever. Oh, and Big Show with a big knee to the gut. Undertaker whipped across the ring. Ducks underneath Big Show. Wow. And is he going to do it? Is he going to choke slam the final? No. Oh, my God. There is no
way in hell.
There's no way The Undertaker.
I told you.
A double choke slam.
The dead man just said nighty night. The dead man at dawn has rung for the last time, Michael.
These two monsters have decimated The Undertaker.
Khali will pay.
But what in the world is a Punjabi prison match anyhow?
Michael, I don't know. I don't think The Undertaker wants to know. I wrestled on 5 continents. I have heard of this match. I didn't think it really existed. Nobody thought it really existed, but it does.
Let's take another look at how these two monsters decimated The Undertaker with the double choke slam. But ladies and gentlemen, the bottom line is this. A week from tomorrow night in Indianapolis, Indiana, The Undertaker and the great Khali will meet for the first time ever in a Punjabi prison match.
And they won't come out the same as they went in.